Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to set up Visual Studio Code for JavaScript and run your first JavaScript program. So let's get started. So just go to Google and type download Node.js. You'll be getting the first link over here as nodejs.org. Just click it and here you'll be having the Windows installer. If you're using Mac, you can use that particular one. I will go with Windows. I'll just click it. So it'll get started and it is about 30 MB in size, so it will just take a few seconds. Yeah, so once it is downloaded, just click it and open when done. So you'll be getting the Node.js setup over here, the dialog box. Just click on next and just click on I accept. You can just like read it through and again click next. And this is the default location where Node.js is going to get installed. If you want, you can change it. I will like keep with the default one and I will click next. So these are some of the things that will be like automatically installed. So you can just like leave it to default and just click on next. Yeah, so this is fine. Just click next again and click on install. So once the installation is complete, just click on finish. And if you just go and search for Node.js, you'll be having this Node.js app. So once you're done installing Node.js, we need to add Node.js path to the environment variable. So just search for Node.js, you'll be getting this Node.js app. And here you'll be having an option called as open file location. Just click it and you'll be having the programs, and here you'll be having Node.js. Again right click it and go to open file location. So you'll be getting the path where you have installed Node.js, which is local disk C, program files and Node.js. Just click here and copy this whole path, and after copying just go to search again and type environment. You'll be having the edit the system environment variables option. Just click on open, and in this you'll be having this environment variables. Click it, and under system variables you'll be having path. Just click on path and then click on edit, and here you can see right C, program files, Node.js has been automatically added. So if it isn't automatically added, you need to just click on new and paste this path and click on OK. So just check if this path has been added already. Okay, so once you're done adding this path, close everything and just go to search and open command prompt. So I will just zoom in a bit. So type node-v. So here you can see that we will be getting the node version here. This means that we have successfully installed Node.js. So also type npm-v. Yeah, so we will be also having the npm node package manager, which allows us to install many packages like libraries and stuff. So now we are done installing with Node.js, and yeah. Next thing we want to download is our IDE, which is Visual Studio Code. Just go to Google and type download Visual Studio Code. You will be getting the first link over here as codevisualstudio.com. Just click that. And here you will be having Visual Studio Code for different OS. There is for Windows, Linux and Mac. I'm going to download it for Windows. So I'll just click on this Windows. Okay. So download will get automatically started. So it is about 88.8 MB in size. So just be patient. So once the download is complete, just click on open and you'll be getting like this license agreement. Just click on I accept. You can just scroll down and read it. Next. So this is the location where Visual Studio Code will be installed. So if you want, you can just browse and change the location. I am fine with the default one. Just click on next and next as well. And here you can like create a desktop icon, and it's always good to have this one. Just check this. Okay. Action to Windows Explorer. Yeah, better to give check everything. And just click on next and install. Such a simple installation process. Okay. Yeah. So once the installation is done, just click on launch Visual Studio Code and click on finish. So first we need to open a folder and we'll be creating a file inside that. So just click on file over here and just click on open folder and just create a new folder in any of your favorite locations. I'll just go to document and right click new folder. So I'll just create this new folder over here and just select that, and you have to click on select folder. Yes. So now we are inside that folder that we created earlier. So you need to click on this new file icon over here. You'll be having this. Just select that, and here you need to type your file name with a .js extension. So I'll just type it as new file .js. Hit enter. So Visual Studio Code automatically recognizes it as a JavaScript file. So here you can see we will be having JavaScript over here. So now we need to install two extensions which will make our coding so easy. So to the left you will be having these extensions. Just click that and just search for JavaScript. we'll be having the first one, JavaScript ES6. So this is like super famous. So this has these many downloads. You can just click on install. So this basically gives us autocomplete and IntelliSense, and this is also fine. And next is going to be the code runner, and you can just click on install. So this helps us to run our JavaScript program. So now we are good. We are done with both the things. Let me just now close this. So let me just have a simple console now. So it's going to be console.log, something like this. So for running it, we have two options. First is through the terminal. So just click on this terminal, new terminal, and make sure that you are inside this particular path. So this is the path that we are having over here inside JS folder. So for running this, it's going to be node space. You need to put your file name with extension. It's going to be new file dot JS. Just hit enter. And the second way is going to be with the help of the code runner. So here we'll be having a play icon. Just click on run code. But rather than typing the command, we have just click on this run button. So this makes our work so simple. So I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I run a lot of videos in C, C++, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL, CRUD operations, as well as AI videos. Check them out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.